Hi, this is Akshay Baheti and welcome to Journal Watch, where we review certain important or interesting radiology articles. This time we are going to review an article which looks at CT assessment of resectability of pancreatic cancer and can we perhaps do a better job. So we all know the NCCN criteria based on which we classify pancreatic tumors as resectable, borderline resectable or unresectable. And we do that based on tumor abutment versus encasement or deformity of adjacent arteries as well as veins. And this is very important because this helps guide patient management. So patients with metastatic disease are given palliative chemotherapy. Patients with borderline resectable or unresectable tumors are given neoadjuvant chemotherapy with or without radiation. And in the post-treatment scan, depending on the response, the patients may or may not undergo surgery. This is done with the hope of downstaging the tumor and giving it the best shot that we have. Patients with resectable tumors, on the other hand, usually undergo upfront surgery, although recently there is a move to give more and more of these patients neoadjuvant treatment prior to surgery as well. However, this is not the only way of prognosticating patients. This is certainly an important way of prognosticating them, but the surgical margins, whether this is an R0 resection or an R1 resection, also plays a major role in improving patient survival. So R0 resection is associated with a much better patient survival compared to an R1 resection. An R0 resection margin essentially means that the surgical resection margin is free of microscopic tumor, whereas an R1 resection margin indicates that there is microscopic disease present at the surgical resection margin. And this is precisely what this recent paper published in Radiology looked at. The authors looked at the diagnostic performance of CT in determining resectability of pancreatic cancer based on the NCCN criteria, and more importantly, whether we can predict an R0 resection margin based on CT criteria. So how did they do this? They looked at around 1900 patients with pathologically confirmed pancreatic adenocarcinoma at their center. They excluded all patients in which a dedicated pancreatic CT protocol was not performed, as also patients in whom the dedicated structured pancreatic reporting was not done. Also, patients who underwent neoadjuvant chemotherapy were excluded from the study. This left them with around 616 patients, which was the study population. Even amongst these patients, many did not undergo surgery because they had metastatic disease or the disease was unresectable or because of poor patient condition. Ultimately, 371 patients had a baseline CT, underwent surgery, and then had pathological evaluation which could be correlated with the CT findings. Important to realize that the authors did not actually look at the CT images. This was a retrospective evaluation only of CT reports. However, the reports were based on dedicated CT pancreatic protocol and were done using a structured pancreatic template created by subspecially trained abdominal radiologists. Importantly, the quality check analysis was there in place. So the authors looked at 125 randomly selected CT images, and the author evaluation of the CT images was concordant with the CT report in 95% of the cases. It is important to remember that this is actually a very high volume center. So Assam Medical Center performs almost 350 pancreatic surgeries annually. And almost half of these patients underwent extensive surgeries with vascular reconstruction or additional organ resection beyond the traditional Whipple's or distal pancreatectomy procedures. This is an example of the structured pancreatic template used at the center, and it's pretty similar to the NCCN template or the RSNACR templates that we use. So what are the findings? Totally, out of the 371 patients, only around 63% of them had an R0 resection. And as expected, it was slightly higher in the resectable tumor category. So around 73% of the patients with resectable disease had an R0 resection margin, compared to 55% in borderline resectable tumors and 16% in locally advanced or unresectable tumors. When the authors analyzed the various CT factors on multivariate analysis, obviously the NCCN CT resectability criteria correlated with an R0 versus an R1 resection margin. And tumor size greater than 4 centimeters also was significantly associated with an R1 resection margin. However, more importantly, the authors analyzed the 235 patients who had resectable disease separately, and tumor abutment of the portomesenteric vein was actually associated with a significantly higher incidence of an R1 resection margin along with the size of a tumor greater than 4 cm. It is important to realize that currently, as per the NCCN criteria, tumor abutment of protomesenteric vein is considered as a resectable disease. In fact, if you look at the details, as the tumor size increases from 2 cm to 4 cm, the R0 resection rate drops from 83% to 29%. Similarly, if the tumor abuts the protomesenteric vein, the R0 resection rate drops from 80% to 59%. What were the positives of the study? I think this was a fantastic study. The methodology was very sound. The authors included only patients with a dedicated pancreatic CT protocol and with dedicated pancreatic templates. But the limitations also were that this was a retrospective evaluation of reports and the CT images were not actually reviewed by the authors. Also, it is important to realize that this was a very high volume center and perhaps the R0 resection margins in lower volume centers would probably not be as high as what we see in this study. However, all said and done, what the authors have conclusively shown is that a larger tumor size, essentially more than 4 cm, and tumor abutment of the protomesenteric vein are associated with R1 resection margins, even in patients with resectable pancreatic cancer based on the current NCCN guidelines. And it's probably this subset of patients which will benefit the most from neoadjuvant treatment prior to surgery. And this is probably where we should pick up our phone, call the referring surgeon and tell them that perhaps they should consider giving neoadjuvant treatment in this subset of patients with upfront resectable tumors. And this is probably the best chance we have of giving the patient an R0 resection margin. I'll end with this photo of Borobudur taken at sunrise. So Borobudur is Asia's largest Buddhist temple at Indonesia, at the town of Yogyakarta, around an hour's flight from Bali. Thank you so much and I hope you enjoyed.